Valentine's Day is almost here, but there is still time to make sweets for our dolls. So let's make our dolls a box of chocolates using index cards for the box. Blank index cards would be the best, but all I have is these. This is a wide rule index card. I carefully cut one of the stripes. I'm going to use this to trace the sides of my box. So I place it onto the index card, right at the edge, draw a line, scoot down just a little, and trace on both sides of the line, making the long sides of the box. Draw the short sides. I am tracing the lines that are already there to draw the shape of our candy box. Carefully cut it out, and remember to always have adult supervision when crafting, making sure to leave tabs on the corners. Fold on the lines drawn, use a glue stick to glue down the tabs to make a small tray. Place it onto the leftover card, carefully trace around it. I want it to be just a little bit larger than the first one. Use the strip to draw the sides, cut it out, fold on the lines. Only this time, I am going to flip it over and fold, glue down the tabs so the inside is blank. I found gold wrapping paper left over from the holidays. I am going to use this to cover the outside of the box. I cut a small square, glue down the bottom of the box, make small cuts at the corners so I can wrap the paper around the edges so it's nice and neat. Repeat for the other side so we have a gold lid for the box. Take a brown candy wrapper, cut it into rectangles. I try to make sure they are all the same shape. I have some takeout chopsticks. Take the large rectangular end, place it in the middle of the brown wrapper, fold the paper around the edge. Add glue, then glue it inside of the bottom of the box. Repeat until it is filled. Now we just need some chocolates. I'm using a thick craft foam. Cut it into small rectangles. Place them into the box to make sure they fit. In a small bowl, mix brown paint and Mod Podge. Stir until well blended. I use a pen to pick up the craft foam, place it into the paint glue mixture. Carefully place it onto clear plastic and allow it to dry. After applying the paint, you might want to blot off some of the excess onto a paper towel. Cover all of the foam and allow it to dry. They've been drying for a while, now they feel pretty good. Take a little white gloss acrylic paint. I'm using a pen to put a few stripes on the chocolate. It took me a few practice tries to get it thin enough, and it worked better when I watered down the paint. Carefully remove them from the plastic and place inside of the box to make a box of chocolates for our dolls. Place the lid on top, and it's done! Or you can add ribbon or a label. I like the idea of a label. So I made a printable where I can cut out a small label and glue it onto the box. So our chocolates have a brand. While I was making the label, I went ahead and made a few printable boxes as well. Just cut it out, glue it onto an index card, cut it out again, glue down the tabs just as before to make a gourmet box of chocolates. The printables make it easy to make a lot of boxes. Only now, we need somewhere to store them. Take giant craft sticks, carefully cut them to about 6 inches. Repeat to make 4. Take a jumbo craft stick, cut it, and glue it across the middle. Glue 2 more on the sides. Take 2 more and glue them at the bottom to make a small platform. Add another one for a shelf. Add a jumbo popsicle stick underneath and at the top. Let's add a giant craft stick going straight out and another one to the side. I glued a few more together, glue it to the back of the shelving unit, glue jumbo craft sticks to the sides, use more to make a box at the top and a shelf. Take one of the leftover pieces, glue it to the bottom along with a wooden dowel to give the counter more support. Cut out the printable sign, glue it to a few layers of cardstock, then glue it to the top. Stock the shelves and decorate. so our dolls can sell their homemade candies. These little chocolates were a lot of fun to make, and if you cut one open, it looks like it has a cream filling. If you don't have time to make all of the little chocolates, you can wrap the foam with a foil paper as an alternative. Thank you for joining us while we made our dolls a box of chocolates and a small chocolate stand. Like, comment, share, and subscribe. Don't forget to ring the bell and follow us on Instagram at MyFroggyStuff and the Frog Vlog.
And you're done.
Happy crafting!
To give a shout out to Creativity of Tan. What's up? What is this? They've added a candy counter to the mall? Now there's no reason to ever leave.